Human behavior has always been a mystery. Why do people do what they do? Why do they react one way when we expected something else? How do we learn to understand, connect with, enroll, engage, align with people most effectively? Hi, I'm Christine Comeford, founder of Smart Tribes Institute, and welcome to our Smart Tribes Crack the Behavior Code podcast. In each episode, you'll learn practical, easy-to-use tools to better understand and change human behavior. These tools will help your team outperform, out-engage, outsell the competition. In other words, to become a smart tribe. Oh, and you'll find these tools super helpful in your personal life too. Let's go.
Are you getting enough hugs? Are you getting enough hugs? Virginia Satir, a world-renowned family therapist, is famous for saying we need 4 hugs a day for survival. We need 8 hugs a day for maintenance, and we need 12 hugs a day for growth. How many hugs are you getting each day? With social distancing, dramatically reduced human contact, and more digital than physical interactions, many of us are running short on hugs. And it's causing mental and emotional health problems, lost productivity at work, reduced intimacy and trust, increased anger and aggression, and that's just a start. And as leaders, it's essential that we take this seriously. The more emotionally and mentally balanced we are, the more we can help our teams to become so. So let's look at why human beings need hugs, and then we'll look at strategies to get more. 4 reasons humans need hugs. Number 1, hugs strengthen your immune system and balance your body. A hug results in some pressure on your sternum, which then stimulates the thymus gland, which then regulates and balances the body's production of white blood cells, which keeps you healthy. Hugs help increase circulation and help balance our sympathetic, fight, flight, freeze, and parasympathetic, rest and digest, nervous systems. All good there. Number 2, hugs increase our feelings of safety. Hugs emotionally feed us. They help us remember that we're not alone, help us feel more trust with others. Ever noticed how relaxed you feel after a juicy hug? Hugs remind us that we are with others and together we can face any challenge. Number 3, hugs increase your feelings of belonging. Hugs boost oxytocin levels, which heal feelings of loneliness, isolation, and anger. Hugging is a shared experience. You're both giving and receiving affection. Nice. Number 4, hugs increase your feelings of mattering or self-esteem, being seen, self-love. Extended hugging, 20 seconds or more, boosts your serotonin levels, causing you to feel happy and more positive emotions overall. When you see another person look at you with kindness and affection, you remember that you're loved. Just like you did as a child when your parents looked at you and acknowledged you were here and they were happy that you were. How to get more hugs. Number 1, ask others and or get a hug buddy. If you live with others, this is easy. If you need to start keeping a daily tag or tally to find out what number of hugs makes you feel most at peace, do that. If you live alone, get a hug buddy. This is a buddy that observes the same social distancing, pandemic protocols that you do. It's essential to be able to relax into a delicious hug. Set times when you'll get together for hugs. You can also sit back to back on the ground and lean against one another for an extended period of time. You could be reading or talking during this time. Number 3, hug and or sleep with your pet. Yes, this is not the same as hugging a human, but still, it's contact with another living thing. So go for it. Many people I know are breaking the rules and letting their dogs sleep on their bed now. Throw a special dog blanket on top to protect your bedding and snuggle up. Number 3, hug yourself. Now, this may sound silly, but it works. Remember, the goal is oxytocin and serotonin release. So you may want to turbocharge this experience by listing all the things you love about yourself. This is about mental and emotional health, friends, and yours is more important than ever. With the pandemic, the recovery from the pandemic, and continued uncertainty. So what's the net? Hugs are good for our mental, emotional, physical, and even spiritual health. Now more than ever, people need hugs. We can get creative to get more hugs and also get proactive by getting hug buddies and tracking how many hugs we need daily to feel good. How will you get more hugs per day?
Thanks for joining me on this episode. Every listen, every share, every review helps others form their own smart tribes where teams are engaged, happy, and optimally performing. Together, you and I can help millions of people crack the behavior code in their organizations, families, and communities. I invite you to take 2 minutes and head over to smarttribesinstitute.com to discover more about how to form a smart tribe. See you there, and please tell your friends.